bars in the penitentiary. I got a that hangs several inches.
I can make it bounce by myself.
Turn it up to 11. into your earlobes like your bleached out hair, dude. We glowing in the dark, got the spark, about to flare the fuse. That's just how we do. To Geronimo, parachute, skydiving off your parents' roof. Crew, saw the magician's assistant in half, like who the f are you? Who the f are you? Who the f are we? We be the dudes who just come over to water the lawn. We don't say hi, we just come over to walk your dog. We nice like that, we super nice like that.
I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. We've got a good one on tap today, and there's going to be two quarterbacks ready to get it done on the gridiron. It's the Rams going up against the Cardinals. So with that, let's get right out to the stadium. Brandon Godden and Charles Davis have the call on this Week 4 matchup.
Thank you very much, Larry. We are about 15 miles west of downtown Phoenix at University of Phoenix Stadium here in Glendale. Today, we've got a good NFC matchup on tap between the Los Angeles Rams and the Arizona Cardinals. They come out here in the eye. On the ground, this is Lamar Miller. A gain of three, second down. And here's a look at the starting offense. So the offense now dealing with a second and seven.
Let's go!
Throwing, Jones. Harris has it over the middle. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. It's a gain of five on the play, and that'll bring up a third down. The starters on defense here for Los Angeles.
Cameron Jordan is now one of those versatile defensive linemen that you can play all up and down the front. Whether he's playing tackle or end, he knows how to make plays.
An early test, two plays in. This is third and two. Now Jones. Well, they would have gotten the conversion if he could hold on. Instead, the drop means it'll be fourth down. So on fourth down, here's Marquette King to punt it away. This is away and a very good kick angled for the sidelines. And this will be out of bounds. Now it's a question of where they'll mark it. And they'll say it crosses at the 11-yard line. First carry now for Tyler Irvin. And he is going to lose yardage here. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. But good luck there as a ball carrier. You get handed that football, look up, oh, there's a big D tackle ready to swallow you whole for a loss.
Yeah, you kind of count on your guys to give you at least a little bit of time, a little bit of space to try and maneuver, but not on that one. And when you have a defensive tackle who is that strong, that agile, he's a lot to deal with. Sometimes you have to double him, and sometimes you're not able to block him no matter who's trying.
So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. On first and 10, here's Bortles. And complete to Lewis over the middle. And he's brought down after a good gain. They get 25 yards out of that one. And that leads to a Los Angeles first down. And some extras coming up on the line here, Redding for the blitz. On first down, Irvin. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
There's so many things that go into playing the position of linebacker. Some of them are actually subtle, doing the drill work that you do all the time in practice and carrying it over to the game. Get rid of blockers and get to the ball carrier, knocking down for a loss.
And the quarterback won't take the snap here. This is the Wildcat look. They'll let their receiver run it out of the Wildcat. And incomplete here. So a little razzle-dazzle on that one. But they couldn't hook up, and it's third down. And this O-line, it is the lifeblood of the offense.
They established the tone. Mean, nasty, physical. They can't wait to get after people. That allows the rest of the offense to feel confident.
An extra DB added here for the Cards on third.
Blitzer play coverage.
Now Bortles. And he fires one that's intercepted. And an alley to run. Picked off by Darquez Denard. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And the first drive, three and out. Second possession. See if they can get a little momentum.
And oftentimes that first drive is just a feeling out process. You have some plays that you've got called and you want to see how defense reacts. It may not go terrific on the first one. Now they're ready to go. They've kind of got a look at them, got a sense. Let's see if they open things up a little bit.
See if they open things up. Let's see what the defense does here, too, after a good stop. He's going to air one out. And they went big on first down. Proves unfruitful. The Pro Bowl wideout Julio Jones is intended receiver. And it's second down.
I know exactly why he tried to throw the ball to Julio Jones there. He's never considered covered. He's either too fast or too strong. You always try and get it to him.
Especially on those deep passes. Unable to connect on the first down pass play. Now it's second down. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Underneath for Miller. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. 6 yards on the pickup, and all of a sudden here, it's third down.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Putting pressure on the guy throwing the football is always good, but when you can couple that with contact on him that leads to an incompletion, as we just saw there, that's winning football.
And Santos able to put this one up and through. It's good. And the Cardinals have the first points. It's 3-0. So after the pick, they can't capitalize for six, but they do get three.
And I know in this situation, most of us wanted to focus on the offense. You know what side of the ball I played on. Let's give that defense a lot of credit. Taking it over in a sudden change situation and shutting them down.
The Rams offense now making their way out to take over. Looked like they had something going last drive. Then the interception happened. Will they recover?
The memory they need to keep with them is that they did have something going. They were moving the ball on offense, had a nice sequence going. Don't worry about the other part. You can't get that back. Let's go back to what you were doing well before.
I thought you were going to say they need to have no memory, but remember the good part, forget the bad.
I like that even better.
Behind the chains here, a touch on second and 11. They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. Bortles now to throw. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he maybe makes it back to the line of scrimmage. That's it. So here we go down. Extra defensive back in there on third and 10. Throwing his Bortles on third down. He rifles one, it's intercepted. Decision to come. lose yardage here. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
A'shaun Robinson coming out of the University of Alabama, a big, physical, intimidating force who had to learn to play with more leverage. Otherwise, he's going to get blown off the ball in the NFL. Looks like he's learning his lessons after that play.
And the offense will be looking to get at least some of this yardage back here. It's second and 12. They isolate Hopkins on the left side. Now Bortles throwing on second down. And here's another interception. This first quarter picked off by the safety, Eric Reed. And the Cardinals offense here ready to take over. And they split the uprights last time for three. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking, because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Run what you do best. Exactly. Put it all the way down and try to increase your lead in a big way. And the best way to do it, touchdowns.
Now a play fake here on first down. Forced down to his left. That eventually taken down. Coverage downfield. Coney Ealy in there to sack him for a loss of six.
Well, Brandon, sometimes I think when we watch games, we're actually watching a living museum, because we're seeing the evolution of positions almost with each passing game. How about defensive ends nowadays and the way that they can run almost all the way across the field?
It is unbelievable, isn't it? I mean, they're so strong, but they're so lean, they can move so quick with those bodies.
It's almost unfair. You're supposed to be able to know where a defensive end is supposed to be on every play. These guys flash so quickly, you're not sure where they're going to end up.
Throwing Jones. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And Jarvis. It's incomplete.
On every offensive coordinator, every play caller sheet, they have about five or six plays per game that they call shot plays or big plays.
Don't
give them any opportunities to dial them up, and they just did. And they drop it with a great chance to make a big play. That's going to hurt.
Now Jones, and he fires one that's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And they are going to set up shop at the 40-yard line. The Rams offense now, they get set and head back onto the field. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious.
Get your ass out of here, man. You want me in your room? Get the fuck out of here.
Attack. We'll see how they attack him here.
Get the fuck out of here.
Let's have the offense responds with a second and 13 now.
Over there, got to watch cartoons and shit before you go to sleep. Let's get
it. Bortles to throw on second down. And he is going to be hit and taken down. Bortles sacked.
Okay, you know my bias is about to come out
what
here.
What you want?
A lot of people think that the offense is just moving in the wrong direction.
Get the fuck out of here.
I'd say they're moving in the right direction because the defense is pushing them back.
Clever defensive guy. Now as a quarterback, third and long, you really got to rally the troops here, don't you?
Yeah, you're doing
it. Don't you turn around, you ugly ass nickel.
More pressure coming at you because it seems to be working pretty well.
And the offense now will try to regroup after the sack on second down. There's some secondary help here for the defense and the nickel on third and long. Bortles gonna throw.
Oh, what can I say?
It's gonna be incomplete. Back live now to begin the second quarter with Charles Davis, Brandon Gordon. It's the Rams with a football to get us going. They are, however, facing a fourth down situation. And here's the all-rookie punter from 2015, Matt Darr, on now to punt it away. This is taken around the 12. Give him 11 yards that time on the return. And the Cards will take over, first and 10. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I'm here with my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. Last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, oh my God.
Turnovers, right? Minimizing. using those and maximizing opportunities. Really tough drive, but that run helped salvage something there because now there's something positive that came out of it. We got to see good blocking, good push by the offensive line, wide receivers trying to get involved, a good run by the back. And now maybe it'll be a catalyst for them to look at going forward, watching it on tape. Maybe they can keep incorporating that type of a run into their offense.
When we sat with the coaching staff a couple of days ago, they said attacking that defensive look with a run, something they wanted to do, it was effective.
And they were extremely confident, weren't they? Their planning, their preparation, they knew what they were going to get in that defense, and they were able to attack it accordingly.
A first down carry now for Miller. And he's across the 43, extra yards to the 43. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and five. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
On second down, here's Miller. And some room.
Give him 30. Oh, my God, he's tired.
Taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A big play there out of the running game. 30 yards.
You know it's really hard for a big-time running back? Is patience. Being able to hang in there when the runs aren't there, when you're taking some hits early in the game. But this drive, oh, he's come alive, and in a big way, now he's starting to gallop.
And now a first down following that long gain. Again, running
yes,
right leg. Leg.
We go, man.
Touchdown now on the year. And the Cardinals will extend their lead.
Well, pardon me, that was another explosive run. And one thing I've learned in our time in this game, yes, the offensive line has to get a lot of credit, but for big runs to occur, the wide receivers have to block well downfield.
And then you have to have a good guy carrying the ball too, right?
Oh, without a doubt. You need that difference maker lugging the rock.
And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. And last drive, three and out. Still a goose egg on the scoreboard. How do they break that goose egg?
They've got to find a way to get the ball in the hands of their playmakers, get them some space, and try and make a first down and get some momentum going. It's been a struggle for them throughout the game, and that three and out on the last possession, that told you just how starved they are on offense.
So who will step up here? We'll see. Second down, here's Bortles. Now they go screen, it's complete. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. Only three there on the pickup, but that's enough to move the chains.
So many things have to come together just right for a screen pass to break for big yardage. The blocking, the timing of the pass to the runner, everything has to fit together just right. But on that play, the defense was able to disrupt things and hold it to a short game.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he is going to lose yardage here. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
With the struggles we're seeing up front for the offense today, they've got to think about changing up their play calling. Some screens, some draws, some quick-hitting plays in order to try and supplement the run game. You don't totally abandon it, but you try and give it a little bit of help. That was a classic example of trying to run with the ball without securing the catch. He was thinking about those rack yards instead of making the catch first and then taking off.
Third down here for the offense after the incomplete pass. From the gun on third down, Bortles. And that's complete to Lewis. And he's brought down after a good gain. That one goes for 29 yards on third down.
Well, the advantage has certainly shifted to the defense as we began that third down play, and they found a way to foil it and pick up a first down.
Third time's a charm, right? Two incompletions. Had to have it on third, and they got it.
Yeah, they stuck with it, weren't daunted at all, and picked it up.
A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves them with a second and 3.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
And he got half of what he needed there, 2 yards. And it'll bring up a third and 2 more.
Tough day, tough sledding right there. And it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. Bortles looking to throw on third and two. And that is incomplete. The intended receiver there, Tyler Urban. And now it's fourth down.
I'm not sure we could spot any tendency here on this third down. They could have run it or passed it. Either one was available. They chose to try and get it through the air, but they were unsuccessful.
And Hopkins' kick is good. And they'll at least get on the board here, still trailing, but 16-3 now. Well, their offense has struggled for sure, but they get the field goal here and at least get on the board before half.
And that's not something we should underestimate, because just getting points on the board can sometimes have a settling effect on a team, helps them start their comeback.
Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And now last drive, so successful with the ground game, ending in a touchdown. Do you stick with that formula?
That would be the number one thing you would think of, but so many guys now would look at it and say, we've got them set up so well for play action, now's the time to take a shot.
Yeah.
But you know, there was a big-time coaching staff. Winston, if you throw the ball, if you put it in the air, three things can happen, and two of them are bad. People catch it on the ground.
And time for us to take a break here in the booth. More from the desert after this. And they're behind the sticks here a bit now, dealing with a second and 12. They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. Completes it right side to Doxson. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and they're going to face a third down. And boy, they had high praise for this rookie receiver when we asked the coaches about him, didn't they?
They certainly did, and obviously they liked his measurables, otherwise they wouldn't have brought him onto the team. Height, weight, speed, all of that. But how about what they really said? Competitiveness. That's what they really liked about him. The way he goes after the football, competes for it, and decides when it's in the air, it's his and only his.
And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game. Looking to throw. The catch made by Miller. And he will have a first down here at about the 40. So there you go, holding by the offense, and that'll push him back.
Changes everything now as you try and figure out what your playbook has for you. Longer yardage situations, tougher to execute and pick up first downs.
And the yellow flag hurts this offense, and now they face a tough third down.
Let's go!
Now Jones, looking deep downfield. It's caught inside the 25. And he'll get it down deep into Los Angeles territory. And they talked about how important the passing game was going to be against that defensive look. Good job there going to the air for the first down.
It's all about preparation. It's all about planning. And then it's about execution. So they put it all together in practice. Okay, this is what we think we're going to see. This is how they get to it. And then when the game comes, read it and attack it.
It's a 10-yard gain there, and it sets them up now first and goal. And now the passing game here in the second quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it. Now the confidence is starting to rise. I think now as a play caller, because that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more. You don't go totally away from running the football, but you do say, guess what? We can throw it. We can throw it well with a whole lot of confidence.
They'll try and run for it with Miller. And he'll be stopped just outside the five at the six. It's a gain of a yard, and it'll set up second and goal. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. Throwing Jones. He's got his man. It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. Julio Jones. His third touchdown now on the year. And the Cardinals now adding on to their lead. And he'll bang that one through. The Cardinals set now to kick this one away, and off we go. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. Here's the Los Angeles offense as they get set to take possession. And tough to win games if you're going field goal, field goal, field goal here. They got field goal last time. Now they'll be looking for a touchdown.
They're looking for the big chunk now because because, as you noted, the field goal way of doing it makes it that much harder. It puts more pressure on every possession for you now. Go ahead and get six and feel a lot more comfortable about the position they're in.
Bigger chunks. We'll see if they can get the score.
And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. On first down, Bortles. And it pops straight. A collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
Bortles will try again on second down. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by the safety, Eric Reed. And his guys are going to take over at their own 48-yard line. So out now come the Cardinals. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that, they had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went.
And this is caught inside the five. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown. Second touchdown of the game, fourth of the year. And the Cardinals will extend their lead. The Cardinals set now to kick this one away, and off we go. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. And the Rams now coming out on the field. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time, do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned they're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk is a big decision here.
And this one will go to the 28-yard line. It's a 9-yard pickup on the play, and it'll be second and about a yard. Bortles to throw on second down. He's going to air one out. And that's one of his advantages of a passer is not with his height. Sitting back there in the pocket, firing over the middle, he can really see everything clearly.
It is, and I know that other quarterbacks get it done different ways, all right? You don't have to be his height to make a great play, but what he does is he takes away having to make those slide steps in the pocket to find angles to throw the ball through. He just throws right over the top of it because he can see everything, and sometimes that saves time and gets the ball to a receiver quicker.
A really good pickup of 28 yards. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times, because he can trust you being in the right spot. And they connected there and picked up a first down.
He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
Well, they went for the big play there. But that drop can really hurt their momentum.
So incomplete on first. Let's see what second down has in store. Bortles again here on second and 10. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete.
I'm playing the fuck out of this shit.
Back
to the air on second down. It's Bortles. Hopkins on the grab over the middle. And he's able to get it down to the 25-yard line. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Throwing is Bortles on third down. He's got it to die. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Into the red zone. It's Bortles. Dancing to his left. And he's brought down. So we reach halftime here in Glendale with the Cardinals on top. As we send you on to Orlando, we hook back up with Larry Ridley. He's got our EA Sports halftime report. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
This is a new
thing. I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. Now Bortles throwing on second down. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. 7 yards on the play, and it'll be third down.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
And 3 full yards here for the offense to get on third down. Bortles going to try and throw on third down. And he's got his big tight end over the middle, complete. The 21 yards there as they convert on third. Well, clearly one of his advantages as a passer is his height, sit back in the pocket, fired over the middle. That makes things tougher defensively, doesn't it?
It really does, because your goal is to move the quarterback off his initial spot when he gets his drop back completed. But when you have that type of height, he can stay in there if he's willing to take the hits and just fire over the top, which saves him time and actually completes a play a little bit quicker than it normally does for a quarterback that has to slide and find open space to throw.
And they'll stop him right on the midfield stripe. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of 2. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. 2nd and 8. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
Out of the Wildcat, a wide receiver carry. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. And still about 3 yards shy of a first as the 4-yard pickup brings it to third down.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
And this defense looks for one more stop here on third after the run. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Now this time Bortles will throw. And he'll be hit as he releases it. And that'll fall incomplete.
Third down is a down. Both sides know they absolutely have to win. And the name of the game for the defense is pressure on the quarterback. But pressure on the quarterback with contact, that's how you end up winning it.
And this is a high kick, but it's not going anywhere. And this ball is going to be down now right at the 10-yard line. Good spot. The Cardinals offense now ready to get their first opportunity here in the second half. They were able to get the ball back here, didn't surrender any points. Now they'll look to add to that lead.
Yeah, how about the boost the defense gave them? Going right out on the field, shutting them down, not giving up any points, and turning the ball back over. They want to do their part now and show them a little respect and some gratitude by scoring some points.
And to get a little more cushion. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave them with a 2nd and 3.
You know how we get focused at end of the half and end of the game situations about how much time's on the board and, you know, what you need to do? Sometimes you don't even have to worry about that. That's just smart football. You know, that kind of a lead, staying in bounds, it burns clock, even in a situation that we're not really focused on it.
He got maybe a half yard at most, but officially they'll be left with a 3rd and 2. The Rams go nickel here defensively on 3rd. Throwing, Jones. And unable to connect. If he had caught it, it would have been a 1st down. Instead, it's 4th.
Today's NFL, these big guys are featured receivers. They move them all over the place to try and find good matchups. And they had one, they were just unable to complete the pass.
He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. This is brought in at the 21. And when it's said and done, it's a 58-yard punt. And the Rams will go on offense here for the 1st and 10. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
No doctor for offense right here. The punter doesn't exist, guys. He doesn't even exist. He's not a team anymore. I just cut him. All right? So you got to go out and create some offense for us here and give us some points. No way does that guy get on the field on this drive.
Poor punter.
Yeah, it wasn't his fault. But hey, listen, if there's got to be casualties at times. We're trying to win a game.
So they complete the pass, and now they face a 2nd down. Yeah, that one was relatively easy to see. I noticed that from up here.
Yeah, it doesn't take a whole lot, does it? Sometimes you get multiples. What I always love on these offsides is when each side points at the other. Hey, you did it. No, you did it. They deciphered that one correctly.
3 yards remaining here on 2nd down. A 2nd down carry for Irvin. And not much room to operate as he'll get this up only to about the 41. They got 2 of the 3 they needed there. It leaves them with 3rd and just 1 yard.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
And he's taken down at the 43, but not before picking up the 1st.
Everyone understood their role on that play. 3rd and 1, you know, the defensive guys, they're trying to get down and get low and get leverage on the offensive linemen, but they didn't allow that to happen. They created a crease and allowed him to get through for a 1st down.
Surveying the field. That is incomplete.
Hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it. No one got it. Second down here after the incomplete pass. They isolate Hopkins on the left side. Bortles again here on 2nd and 10. And his throw's going to be incomplete. The Pro Bowler DeAndre Hopkins, the intended receiver. And it's 3rd down. Ten yards to go on 3rd. From the gun on 3rd down, Bortles. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. A big play there on the catch and run. 52 yards.
As we continue to advance in the NFL, as people continue to scout players, they really don't care as much about body types as they care about those guys who could make people miss, run through tackles, and gain all that additional run after catch. Anybody has that ability, they want them on their team.
Give him 4 on the carry there. It's 2nd and goal.
When you look at the geography we're staring at, this part of the field, don't you always think of big backs carrying the football, bruisers trying to pound it in? Instead, look at a little more of a step back type, and he's trying to make it happen.
The elusive, slippery guy couldn't get in there, though. He lost 2 there, and it's 3rd down.
I didn't have to stretch for this one. This is four down territory. They've got to get it in with the deficit that they're facing.
Absolutely. It's not the fourth quarter, but still, I think you can't be thinking three here.
No, if you do that, you might as well go ahead and fold up on this one, but I don't think they're built like that.
Bortles looking to throw on third and two. And oh, they almost had another one. They are all over the football in this game. Nearly another pick. Now fourth down.
Well, an incomplete pass certainly doesn't look like a good play. For the guy throwing it today, as many interceptions he's thrown, he's going to feel a sigh of relief that the ball actually hit the ground and didn't go in the other direction.
Well, I guess we're at the stage here where they wouldn't say no to any points, but I don't think field goals are what they're looking for here in the second half.
I don't either, Brandon. When you're down as much as they are, that's a sign of a head coach waving the white flag to me.
And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. Here's the Arizona offense now as they get set to take over. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense. Get a couple of first downs and hopefully flip the field.
Well, there's something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. And they work his way across the 30 to the 32. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards. And it's second and two. Offense in a good spot here. Second and two. Here's the option going right, and he went nowhere. He'll lose yardage back to the 29, so he loses 3 yards there. Now third down.
And on this play, the read for the quarterback was the defensive end, and he was totally focused on the quarterback. He should have given it off inside to the running back. Instead, he kept it and ended up taking a loss on the play.
Back now here on EA Sports. A lot of happy faces in the crowd at this point as their guys have a big lead here to start quarter number four. And the offense in that middle ground here on third down, 5 yards to go.
Come on, let's go!
Now Jones. He's going to loft it deep right sideline. And a shot taken on third down, unsuccessful. Fourth down now. Here's Marquette King now as he's on to punt for Arizona.
I guess they figure with a guy who is that hot downfield, who knows how to get the ball into the end zone, you throw it up and give him every opportunity, even though that one fell incomplete.
Yeah, he's already been in the end zone multiple times. Tried to target him again deep there, but unsuccessful. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 points.
The kicker.
Exactly. You put it through the post, that's going to help him at contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him at contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about
toe
that.
Toe bashed it.
Super toe.
Offense comes to the line now, first and 10.
Tight end right, tight end right.
Throwing on first down is Bortles. Looking middle, and it's incomplete.
If you're a defender, one of the fun things about playing zone defenses, especially in today's football, is that it's not as static as it was in the good old days, meaning you just dropped to a point and reacted to the football. Now you end up with a lot of man-to-man principles once you get into your zone defense. In other words, get to your assignment and then locate a guy coming into your area, and then you end up covering him almost man for man. That allows him to make more plays on the football like the one we just saw there.
Bortles will try again on second down. Hopkins on the grab over the middle. And this one will go to the 28-yard line. 4 yards on the pickup. And just like that, it's third down.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
It'll be a 2-yard gain, and that's going to make it fourth down.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
Now Bortles, got to have this one. They go with the screen. It's Yeldon. And he's going to have a first down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line. 14 yards there on the pickup, and they're able to pick up the conversion here on fourth down. On first down, Bortles. And his throw is incomplete.
I wouldn't be shocked at all right now if there's a look of surprise on the big fella's face, because he had the route that he wanted, running the corner. And usually he's able to use his body and catch the football, but a really nice play by the defenders, able to knock it away.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll set up a third down.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. He'll take that any time you hand the ball to a back.
Play number seven now coming up on the drive. Third and five. They isolate Hopkins on the left side. Shotgun now for Bortles. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Whitney Merciless in there to pick up his second sack now of the afternoon. Critical one here if they're going to have any shot at this thing. So they'll go for it on fourth down. Got to try it here. He's back to throw. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. Give him 23 yards on the pickup. And they're able to move the chains as they convert on fourth and long. Throwing now is Bortles. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got...
Hello, my name is Kamal. I am from the clouds. I'm a human now, but I used to be your ranger. Word up, I'm really good at putting words up. I make them levitate and circle with the birds. I don't need to force it, I let it occur. Whatever occurs, thank you. Feel like I was touched by an angel. Once again, a whole nother angle. I got a lot of holes in my ankle. I got a lot of love and a whole lot of ignorance. And that's a good thing if you want to relate. It's come out like a power with an M. I get down like gravity, rap, raggedy, rap, as a rap, rapidly follow the rabbit into the rabbit to being rabbit, unraveling rattle riddles and ribbons into the sky. I'm a rabbit. Some time the pressure keep pressing. Worst case, my impression and breath. That's the way to relate. I'm trying to relate. I'm trying to relate. I'm trying to relate.